What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of this week's Fan Mail of the Week. I'm your host, Unreview Entertainment Gaming, and what a week it has been. Grand Theft Auto 5, Dragon Ball Z, Battle of Gods, so many things happening. I really do hope you guys have been enjoying your week. Anyways, before I get into this week's episode, I just want to show you guys quickly how to send me Fan Mail of the Week. Now, as you can see right now, when you go to my channel, go to the About section. I always tell you guys where to go if you want to send me fan mail, but apparently not a lot of people get the drift. So when you go on my channel, go to the About Me section, and then when you go to that section, scroll down until you see something called Send Message. When you do that and you see that, you are able to send me a fan mail question. Just to get that out the way, I really do hope you guys have been enjoying everything. It is October. It is finally October, which means Halloween is coming up. Thanksgiving is really not far away. Christmas is right around the horizon, and the new year is upon us. So do we have a lot to get through with today? Anyways, guys, let's begin with our first question of the day, which is from...
Hey Alex, what's up? I'm Lucky Speeder right here for Warhawk, and I'm currently doing a Fan Mail Week. If you like a Dragon Ball Z show, I can't really tell, I'm off track. It's Goku, Super Saiyan 3. Now, I've got some questions for you. Number one, sorry if you seem looking down, but I'm rather beautiful as I'm anyway. Question number one, is Super Saiyan good a form or a power-up? Because like with Super Saiyan, each time he could do it, he could do it a lot easier, but with Super Saiyan God, once he did it once, did he need the six Saiyans to do it again? Or could he just automatically do it? And I thought, what's it called? A form, which, like, you can hold it for as long as you can to be powering it out. But with Super Saiyan God, he does it into a time limit, so I don't know, but is that a power up, or what do you think? Question two, would you ever do shout outs? Like, if you think someone's good enough to deserve a shout out, would you ever do it? Question three. Now, you don't have to answer this question, but I love if you do. With the terrorist attack on the Twin Towers 9/11, do you think that it wasn't just Al-Qaeda doing it? Do you think that there was some other message inside of that, such as George W. Bush, I think he was in, or whoever in, wanted to do that, that way he can go into their countries, get all the resources in that, and say it's because of a terrorist attack and gain money from the military? Question four. I have some backyard wrestling videos which I'd love for you to check out, because I love pro wrestling. Private wrestlers definitely. Yes, Danny Bryan. Anyway, I'll put them in down the line. Hopefully you could look at one of my videos. Question five. With ZEQ2 Lite Revolution 5, I have all the characters. Well, I go into the script and it's like players, so they have all the characters, but it only shows a few. Do you know what else can happen? Do you know how you can help me with that? Because it's quite weird, actually. Question six. When you get into WWE, will you want to be a heel or a babyface? Guys don't know what that is, in brackets, good or bad. Question seven. I would love if you could maybe check my YouTube channel, because you're so amazing, Alex. If you don't have time, that's fine. I know you work hard for a wrestler. Anyway, hopefully you could. Question eight. Could you maybe do a series like my first girlfriend, my first kiss, etc., etc.? That would be really awesome if you could, man. Thumbs up, I'd definitely love that. And have you heard the new Linkin Park song? A Light That Never Comes featuring Steve Aoki. Getting a lot of hate, but it's not on the album, so I don't really know what people are complaining about. It's Linkin Park, I love it for a thick and thin. Hopefully you enjoyed this game now. I heard you wanted video responses. Anyway, Alex, hopefully you like this video. God bless, Alex. Let's get him to number one. Subscribe on YouTube. No way you guys don't do it. So yeah, get Alex to number one. Thanks, y'all. See ya!
You, my friend, are awesome. And nice shirt, by the way. Thanks for the fan mail questions, bro. To answer your first question, Super Saiyan God, is it a form or is it a power-up? I've always stated in my opinion that I believe it was a power-up. Because we saw in the movie that when he fought Bills, eventually his power-up ran out. Especially when they were fighting, deep underground. And I personally feel like it's a power-up than a form. Because he had to take... you know, everybody else's power in order for him to ascend to a godlike level. I personally feel like in the next movie, I feel like Akira Toriyama should introduce a full-fledged form. Having a Super Saiyan God form, it makes sense, but I feel like it resembles too much of Kaioken. I really do hope that Akira Toriyama remembers what Kaioken is, because that's what it resembles. You know, the red hair, the red aura, and all that kind of stuff. You know, it kind of reminds me of when Goku fought Vegeta, when he went, you know, Kaioken times 10, and then when he fought, you know, Captain Ginyu and all that kind of stuff, and Frieza, he went Kaioken times 30 and 40 and all that kind of stuff. So the higher the Kaioken went, you know, the more energy he used, and the more the aura would resemble a reddish appearance. So I feel like Super Saiyan God is more of a power-up than a form. If it is a form, then by God, I mean, damn, they could have done a lot more with that, you know what I mean? That's what actually made Dragon Ball Z, was crazy hair and big muscles and all that kind of stuff. That's what actually made Dragon Ball Z what it is, you know? Goku, I mean, he looks so slimmed down, and he looks like, he looks toned, but he looks nothing like his previous forms. Like Super Saiyan 3, he's all jacked up. Super Saiyan 4, even though Super Saiyan 4 isn't canon, Super Saiyan 4, he was all jacked up. So I think Super Saiyan God is just like a scrawny little form, and I feel like Super Saiyan God should be like, you know, an epic form, you know, something that just looks beyond anything what anybody else can ever comprehend. So to answer your second question, I do shout outs all the time. I do shout out videos where I recommend channels, and actually, come to think of it, I haven't done one of those in a while. I just might go ahead and do another one. I do shout out to my videos, I shout people out, I shout channels out, so I do shout out videos, yes I do. To answer your third question, was there a message involved in 9/11? Absolutely. I mean, in case you haven't been checking out a couple of my previous videos, I've always mentioned that I felt like 9/11 was a cover-up, that 9/11 was an inside job, that George W. Bush was definitely involved because he had some intelligence on what was going on prior. So I feel like there was more to it than just your standard, you know, Patriot Act. I felt like we wanted to go in there and invade for resources, to invade and see what's going on with oil and whatnot, and just pretty much control, you know, ushering in, you know, the Patriot Act and, you know, the Homeland Security and stuff like that. And it's just wrong, because nobody should be able to trade their freedom in for security, you know what I mean? There were a lot of hidden messages in 9/11, and sure, a lot of people are going to say, oh, that's impossible, you know, what really happened was a bunch of Talibans, you know, they hijacked the plane, they crashed the plane into the buildings. All right, first of all, there is irrefutable factual evidence supporting that the towers, you know, were not, you know, able to just go down by a couple of planes, you know what I mean? There is irrefutable factual evidence stating that there were explosives in the building, you know, and these were investigators and firefighters that have come out and said, listen, we found traces of explosives in the building. So if you saw the way the buildings went down, it's very, very hard to believe, you know, that what, 2 to 3 planes were able to take out, you know, 3 buildings. You guys are forgetting about building 7, you know what I mean? Whatever happened to building 7, you know, nobody wants to talk about building 7, you know? That building was never struck by a plane, and yet that still went down, you know what I mean? So much conspiracy, so much cover-ups, but I do believe that it was definitely a conspiracy, that it was definitely a cover-up. Will we ever know the truth? Probably not. I feel like the only person that knows the truth is probably God and George Bush himself, because George Bush was in on it. So I feel like the government is never ever going to come out and pretty much reveal what happened, due to the fact that it might create, you know, a massive amount of people that are going to revolt against the government, and thus probably, you know, ensuing a revolution. So I personally feel like we will never ever get any disclosure for 9/11, and it's just very sad, you know what I mean? Like, people paid with their lives. And even though this happened, you know, a decade ago, it still doesn't change the fact that it can always happen again. But in the end, do I feel like there was more to the story than it was being told? Absolutely. But we will never know, man. I'm telling you that right now. To answer your next question, ZEQ2 Revolution. All right, you pretty much have to download the entire patch. You have to download the entire folder. I'm not really sure about the characters, because when I got mine, I pretty much got everything right then and there, because I actually followed the instructions. I had to be very careful because you had to move certain folders around. I'm not entirely sure on what your issue is with ZEQ2, so I can't really, you know, pretty much make my conclusion on what to do. But from what I feel like you should do is just uninstall everything and then re-download everything. But make sure you also follow the instructions and go to the frequently asked questions, just so you can see if you can find anything you're looking for, because you might not be the only one with that problem. I had a problem when I downloaded ZEQ2 Revolution 3, I believe, and I didn't get like any character except for Goku and Frieza. I pretty much did what I had to do and I didn't get anything, so I just uninstalled everything and I moved on. So what you ought to do is just uninstall everything and re-download, and if that doesn't work, then just, you know, go to the frequently asked questions and see what you can do about it, because I really don't know what the problem is, so I can't really say. But that's pretty much what I would recommend, dude. To answer your next question, heel or face, I would love to be a heel first. That's exactly what I would do. If I was a heel, I would definitely have fun, because I would definitely piss the people off. I definitely know how to play that role very, very, very good. I know how to play the face role really good also, but I feel like being a heel, I would have a lot more fun. So I would have to say heel. To answer the following question, will I be able to check your channel out? I've actually checked your channel out before, but if you want me to do it again, I will check your channel out as soon as we're done with Fan Mail of the Week. To answer your next question, will I do a series called My First? I'm not gonna lie to you, probably not, because I have done videos where I pretty much have told you guys, you know, some of my first things. Will I do more of it? Probably, yeah. Will I do an entire series on it? Well, I'm gonna have to retract my statement then. Rather than saying no completely, I'm gonna have to see where I stand on that. But is it a possibility? Sure. But like I said, I've done so-called my first videos before, and I'm pretty sure I'm gonna do more in the future, so all you have to do is just stay tuned, man. And to answer your last question, Linkin Park, the new song, I did not hear the new Linkin Park song. I'm definitely gonna have to hear it after this song is over, because there was a subscriber that recommended Prince EA I Know Who Killed Hip Hop video, so I watched that, and that was pretty epic. So just by you referring that new Linkin Park song, I'm definitely gonna have to check it after this. But thank you for the questions, my good sir. Moving on to the next question, which is from, holy crap, Saiyan Gamer from Earth. Hey Alex, just felt like asking some questions. Please answer. You're awesome. You know this already. Everyone knows it, and you should know. Thank you, man. All right, question number one. Are you excited for 2014 Godzilla and X-Men Days of Future Past? Question two. Should Sonic the Hedgehog be in the next SSB game? In my opinion, he should, but that is just my opinion. I respect yours. Super Smash Bros. Very interesting. Question three. If you think about coming back to the Sonic universe, don't play these games. Sonic 06 from 2006, you know that one. Sonic Genesis for Game Boy Advance, Sonic and the Secret Rings. You know what? I'll shut up now. I could go on to so many more, because in the past, Sonic was bullcrap for a few years, but let's move on. Question four. If you became the most subscribed on YouTube, who would you thank, and could you shout me out if you did? Question five. This is the start of a fanfic I am writing, by the way. When you're done reading it, don't read on fan mail. Oh, okay, fine. I will not read on fan mail then, but it looks like you have a very interesting story going on right there. Holy crap. And at the bottom it says, I want your honest opinion, so please tell me what you think. I look up to you more than you know. P.S. I hope you enjoyed. P.S.S.S. I think Paul is cool. Just to tell you, I respect both of you equally. Thank you very much. I'm definitely going to read that, because it just looks... Let me see here. I'm just going to read it anyway. Here we go. The story goes as follows. Once Goku and his friends have left Earth, the Earth had been taught how to protect itself. Gohan had actually written books about ki control and many other things that Earthlings have learned to use. The Z Fighters actually flew around the world to teach some certain people willing to listen if they had left the Earth to humans to protect themselves. Okay, well, so you're pretty much saying the humans can protect themselves now. All right. They had revealed themselves to the Earth. Very few had believed in their abilities, while others brushed it off to the side. But now the Earth has some Earthlings who have mastered Ki. These people are very powerful humans of Earth, and luckily some have a pure heart and wish to protect their home. Even with this power, the Earth is not prepared for what is yet to come. Oh, shit. All right. Before Planet Vegeta was destroyed, Frieza's mother, Degree, had taken Saiyans for her own use. Some tried to fight back after the planet's destruction, but were killed if necessary. Degree was actually a very calm creature. She was she even cared for her Saiyans, but that did not last long. After many years have passed, she began to hate Saiyans more and more since she heard Goku try to kill Frieza and Trunks succeeded. When Degree heard this, she killed off more and more Saiyans until only a few were left to suffer. She wanted to go kill them herself, but she was nowhere close powerful enough. These Saiyans, after their parents and ancestors have been treated the way they agree, by the time the Majin Buu was destroyed, Degree had left 6 Saiyans, 3 males and 3 females. The creature had now become pure evil with hatred towards the Saiyans, so she locked them up just to see them diminish in front of their very eyes. During short periods of time, every 6 years, she would decide to kill 2 of them. To continue the Saiyans race, they paired up and had children the day before some had their life taken away. This is a fucking very depressing story. What the fuck is... Damn, dude. Alright, the Saiyans could easily escape, but Degree didn't care. She and her guards could easily kill them. So the day before she was supposed to die, 2 of them took their infant child and put them into space pods and sent them to Earth because all of them had heard before... That's where Goku and Vegeta was. That's where they want to go. All of those children have been raised by one person living in the same place that Goku was sent, Mount Post. Okay. Her name was Jinsei, I think it is. I can't pronounce that. And she raised the first 2 Saiyans that be sent. She named them... Hammy? I cannot pronounce those words. Luckily, she was one of the pure-hearted and most powerful Earthlings, so she would teach them ki control and many martial arts techniques. When the third child arrived, Jinsei was crushed by the third Saiyan pod. With her last breath, she named him Draco, and told the other Saiyans to teach him everything she had taught him. Oh well, that was very interesting and very, you know, just chaotic. Holy crap. All right, to answer your first question, am I excited about Godzilla 2014 and X-Men? I am extremely excited about Godzilla, especially because we haven't had a Godzilla movie since 1999, and quite frankly, that movie wasn't all that good. So am I excited for the new Godzilla movie? Absolutely. I mean, I really cannot wait for that. We're only a couple of months away, so let's just see how that goes. As for X-Men Days of Future Past, first I want to see where they're headed in terms of direction. I want to see what they're planning on doing, if they're going to, you know, have some sort of, you know, connection to the Avengers or whatnot. But definitely I want to see where they're headed towards in terms of storyline and how they're going to play things off. But Godzilla especially, man. To answer your second question, Sonic and Shide of Super Smash Bros. That would be very, very cool, actually. I would love to see Sonic inside of Super Smash Brothers. I mean, then you can see, you can have Sonic versus Pikachu, Sonic versus Samus and whatnot. It'll be really, really cool. So, I do agree on the fact that Sonic should be in Super Smash Brothers. But let's face facts. Will he ever be in Super Smash Brothers? I mean, as much as we all want him to, I doubt they're going to make that happen. But if he were to be in Super Smash Brothers, that'll be incredible, I'm telling you. But will he be in the next Super Smash Brothers game coming out, I believe next year or the year after, I'm not really sure. But in the next Super Smash Brothers game, will Sonic be in it? I don't think so. I mean, we have the villager who's in it and whatnot. We have a bunch of new characters, but is Sonic one of them? No, he's not. But will I personally like to see Sonic in Super Smash Brothers? Hell yeah. Because then I can get I get to whoop ass with Sonic, and then I can still remain undefeated as I beat Paul and Sean in Super Smash Bros. But moving on, to answer your third question, am I thinking about going back to the Sonic universe? I mean, honestly, at this point, I'm not, because I don't really have any interest in Sonic anymore. Sonic was great when I was growing up, but then, you know, as the years, you know, go on and as you get older, it's just I drifted away from Sonic, you know, like a lot. I've really drifted away from Sonic a lot. So, am I planning on going back onto the Sonic franchise? Probably not, man, I'm telling you. To answer your fourth question, who would I thank? Obviously, I would thank you guys, because who else would I thank besides you guys, you know what I mean? You know, if by some chance I was the number one most subscribed person on YouTube, I wouldn't know what to do. I mean, seriously. That's a huge milestone, you know what I mean? PewDiePie is the most subscribed to person in the world right now. And I fucking love PewDiePie. I actually would have loved it, you know, if he would have, you know who I was. But, you know, the chances of that happening is very slim. But, yeah, he's the number one most subscribed to person on YouTube. And I condone him for that. And if that was me, trust me when I say I would do so many fucking giveaways. I would do so many things. Like, you guys have no idea. But definitely, the first set of people I should thank is the subscribers, because if it wasn't for them, you know, you wouldn't get nowhere. So and could I shout you out? Shout outs to Mr. Saiyan Gamer from Earth. Now on to your little fanfic. As much as I would like to see that, honestly, I don't think that's a good idea. And this is why I say that. First of all, Frieza's mom. Alright, we never really knew who she was, nor did we know what she did or whatnot. But comparing your story to another story that I read that was similar, I think that Frieza's mom should have been evil from the get-go. I love the story in Dragon Ball AF where Frieza's mom seduced Goku in his dreams to create the ultimate being, half Saiyan, half God. That would have been extraordinary, you know, like having Xeor go to Earth and, you know, fight everybody off and just eradicate everybody, eradicate Super Saiyan 4 Gohan, eradicate Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta, eradicate Majin, eradicate Gogeta, you know what I mean, until Super Saiyan 5 Goku showed up and then, you know, the bar was raised. But in terms of your story, I feel like rather than going back into the past, I think they should go, you know, more into the future. I have no problem with people revisiting the past and saying, oh, well, you know, let's go back to before, you know, Planet Vegeta was destroyed. But let's go after that, you know what I mean? Let's go after the Majin Buu saga. Hell, let's go beyond, you know, Battle of Gods at this point. Let's tell a story that can actually capitalize on certain aspects. Like, let's say, for example, we can tell a unique story after Battle of Gods. Let's say after Battle of Gods, Goku's training, Vegeta's training, everybody's training because now they know who Bills is, and now they know what to expect. Let's say everybody's training and whatnot, you know, maybe King Kai can, you know, go on ahead and say, listen, Goku, I felt a surge of energy, like, in this quadrant of the universe, and I have a feeling that it may be your dad, you know what I mean? So Goku, you know, automatically is shocked, and he wants to see Bardock, so, you know, he teleports into the whatever place that King Kai told him to go to, and there you see an old Bardock, you know, not like super old, but like, you know, he has like facial hair and he's kind of old, but he recognizes his son. And, you know, then from there we can incorporate a canon Bardock, you know what I mean? Just so many things they can incorporate, even Frieza's mom for that matter, you know what I mean? They can definitely tell a story with her. But from your story, it's more based on slavery, if you think, because Frieza's mom was holding Saiyans captive and doing whatever she wanted with them, you know what I mean? That's slavery. Do I like your story? I do. But do I think it would fit the description of the Dragon Ball Z realm? I personally don't think so. But I mean, hell, I mean, your story, if you incorporated more, and if you actually went in depth more with Saiyans rather than humans, then I think the story would be a lot more interesting. But your story is great. I just feel like they shouldn't go to Earth and just be humble and good. You know, like if I were you, I would make it to where Frieza's mom taught those Saiyans how to be evil rather than good. You know, rather than go to Earth and seek, you know, help and whatnot, they were sent to Earth to destroy. So to me, that would make, you know, a lot of sense considering the fact that who Frieza's mom is, you know what I mean? But that's just my opinion. But thank you for the questions, my good sir. Let's move on to the next question, which is from, damn, look at that, another freaking giant essay to read. Damn it. Ready, rules. Hi, bro. It was nice chatting with you a while back on Skype. First, I want to thank you for everything you did on this channel. Every time I am bored, I am looking at your old videos. Family Guy Multiverse was great. And I got some news. They've shown new trailers of Battle of Gods, Super Saiyan God Transformation in HD. I am a great Bardock fan. I can't wait for you to do anything Bardock related. All right. Question number one. Super Saiyan God Bardock or Omega Shenron? Question number two, how do you talk with Paul and Sean on PC games like Minecraft and Dragon Ball Online? Do you use Skype chat? Question 3, do you add subscribers on PSN? If you do, check your Skype inbox, smiley face. Question 4, want to hear what if stories? What if Goku never got the Potara earrings and said, hey, Vegeta, we have to do the fusion technique. Vegeta was like, all right, Kakarot, let's do this. What the fuck? We have to do this ridiculous dance. Let's just get on with the fusion, huh? And so, well, the fight goes on between Gogeta versus Super Buu. Question number 5, do you think it's stupid that the Xbox One and PS4 has no backwards capabilities? Question 6, can I join you in Mind Wars 3? I want to join 2, but you didn't pick me, sad face. Question 7, why the heck do you hate Yamcha? Really, is that a question? For obvious reasons. Question 8, how is Heather doing? You bastard. Got that name for your Mikog video. You monkey. Question 9, imagine a what-if story that Bardock is training with King Kai. Bardock can turn into a Super Saiyan King Kai. King Kai says, Goku, I have a special fighter who loves to fight you, but he is not ready yet. Be prepared when I get him ready. He will be stronger than Cell and a regular Super Saiyan 2, because he can turn Super Saiyan 1 and 2 during his training. Goku is like, okay, I'm excited. So when the time is coming, Bardock figured out when they were fighting in Super Saiyan 1 forms that his son does not only know yet. All right. After the battle, he will kind of cry and say, I would have never imagined you could be so strong. I'm sorry. I was never a good father to you. Saddest moment ever and more to come. I know more freaking what if stories. You will enjoy hearing me out next time. Question 10. Is Paul afraid of showing his face on his channel? Yes, because he looks like Osama bin asshole. I'm just kidding. Question 11. Did you know that I know a part of The Last of Us you will actually make you cry? It's about Tess. You better remember this moment you read this question because it will happen. You'll shed tears like hell. Question 12. I can't wait to see you in Dragon Ball Online. I know a way to remove your scouter. Really? I need to get that shit off my fucking head. All right, question number 13. Not a question, just a comment. You said something about Mind Wars. What number comes after 9? I know what you mean. Mwahaha. With 9, you mean September, and 9 is 10. So will you do Mind Wars 3 in October, aren't you? I'm not going to say nothing. Question 14. Don't you think to get Goku and Vegeta to go Super Saiyan God forms, you'll need 12 Saiyans instead of 6? Question 15. Did you know that Funimation finally licensed Dragon Ball Z Kai Buu Saga? They better make a better scene of Super Saiyan 3 Goku. That scream was more than awesome. Question 16. What you said on Facebook really hit me. I don't only see you as fans. I see you as friends. You really mean that, don't you? Question 17. Damn, so many questions, my God. Have you ever played any games of the Uncharted series? I would love to hear your review. Question 18. I got some what if moment for certain people to go on a Super Saiyan level. When Majin Vegeta wanted to fight Majin Buu, he was powering up like crazy. Well, what if he turns Super Saiyan 3? Question 19. What if there is a Super Saiyan form with 6 pure evil Saiyans, a Super Saiyan evil god? I hope you answer them in your next fan mail. P.S. See you in Dragon Ball Online. Just 2 Dragon Balls for my Super Saiyan form, you bastard. P.S.S.S. You forgot to call me Red, just like my other fan mail from a few weeks ago, you troll face, you bastard. P.S.S.S.S.S.S. Thank you and Paul. I've learned Braga and Spraga and Shabraga. Oh, you fucking asshole. Oh, my God. All right. Well, thank you for the questions, man. Jesus Christ, you wrote me like a giant essay. All right. To answer your first question, Super Saiyan God Bardock or Omega Shenron, you can't really say because Super Saiyan God Bardock doesn't even exist. Even if he were to exist, we don't know how powerful the actual form is. Remember, like, even when Goku executed the form, we never really saw how powerful the form really is. So, considering how fucking beast Omega Shenron is, I can't really say anything about Bardock yet. But until we actually know how powerful a Super Saiyan God really is, then we can say for sure. But for now, I doubt we can make any reference to who would win. To answer your second question, yes, we do use Skype chat. Normally, we all go on Skype and we just Skype on there. But that's only for PC games. Everything else is just Xbox Live. To answer your third question, I've actually tried to add people on the PSN. I've tried to remove my freaking preference settings, but I couldn't find it, so I pretty much gave up on that. I actually need to go back and finish a couple of episodes, like The Last of Us and whatnot. So definitely stay tuned for more, you know, PlayStation videos, because I'm not done, not even in the freaking long run. To answer your fourth question, Gogeta versus Super Buu, that would be really awesome. Can you imagine if Gogeta actually fought Super Buu? I think that fight would be very equal. Vegito was far above Super Buu. I think Gogeta would as well. I think Gogeta would be far above Super Buu as well. But I think the fight would be a lot more lenient. I think Gogeta would actually, do as much damage as Vegito did. But in an aspect, I do believe that in the end, instead of Super Buu absorbing Gogeta, I do think his timer would run out. Just like Omega Shenron versus Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, I think that's exactly what's going to happen. Like, their timer runs out, and then they're like, fuck, we have to do something. So, to answer your fifth question, yes, I do feel like it's stupid that the Xbox One and PS4 does not have backwards capabilities and compatibilities, because it's just stupid. All they have to do is incorporate this little chip that pretty much can register your old games, but they don't want to do that because they feel like they're wasting money and they want to market off the current generation consoles, which is complete bullshit, because I feel like you're just ripping the fans off. So to me, I just feel like it's just a hunk of shit, because if you really wanted to give back to the people, then you would enable backwards compatibilities, you know what I mean? It does not make any freaking sense to me whatsoever. To answer your sixth question, Mind Wars 3, if you want to be a part of it, like I said, all you have to do is just message me, so I'm definitely going to try to put you in there, Mr. Red. But Mind Wars 3, we're not going to start it until, you know, we have the green light, so you are just going to have to stay tuned for that. To answer your seventh question, why the heck do I hate Yamcha? Well, for the simple fact that he's useless, and he's pretty much useless, so F Yamcha. To answer your eighth question, how is Heather doing? I really don't know, and at this point, I really don't care about Heather, so moving on. To answer your ninth question, I think that'll be very, very awesome, like Bardock versus Goku, you know, and then Goku completely whoops Bardock's ass, and Bardock starts crying. He's like, I never knew how strong you'd become. Wow, I'm just really ashamed that I wasn't never there for you. Like you just said, that would be very awesome, saddest moment ever, you know. Bardock goes to his knees, he starts crying, he's like, why was I never there for you? It was my fault, you know, but because of my selfishness, you became a better person, and thank you for that, and stuff like that. So I think, if Bardock would have encountered Goku, that would be incredible. I mean, I still believe that Goku would whoop his ass, because Goku knows every form of, like, martial arts. You know, he's a martial arts master. You know, this dude is a freaking beast. So I personally feel like if Goku were to fight Bardock, I think that'll be an incredible story. And I think towards the end of that fight, we would learn a lot about both father and son. So to answer your 10th question, why doesn't he show his face? I have no idea. That you're going to have to ask Mr. Pear. I mean, I have no freaking idea. Maybe he looks like Eric Cartman's asshole. I don't know. I mean, sorry, pal. I mean, but he's planning on doing some stuff here and there, so you might want to go check him out and stay tuned for that. But in terms of him showing his face, I have no idea. I really don't know. Maybe it's because he doesn't have a face cam. I have no idea. To answer your 11th question, you're talking about a part of The Last of Us that's going to make me cry, eh? Well, let's put that to the test, little man. Let's see if it's going to make me shed tears like you say it will. To answer your 12th question, you know a way for me to remove my scouter. Please tell me, because I really fucking hate my scouter. I mean, absolutely. I cannot stand that thing for the life of me. To answer your 14th question, 12 Saiyans instead of 6. I don't really think so, because, all right, let's say they make Goku a Super Saiyan God first, right? Can't they just put Vegeta in that same circle and then get Goku to pour out his energy as well? I doubt you need fucking 12 other Saiyans, you know what I mean? Like, instead of there being 6, I highly doubt, like, you need, like, 2 sets of 6s. But I just feel like, man, I just feel like Super Saiyan God should have been a transformation, not something that you give your powers to. That's what pisses me off the most. Like, knowing that Super Saiyan God had so much potential, it's like, I really wish that that it was a transformation rather than an ability where you get your powers from other people. So, But do they need 12 Saiyans? I mean, I really doubt they need 12. I think 6 is fine. You know, especially if Goku and Vegeta swap places and Goku's giving his energy now to Vegeta. I think that makes a lot more sense, you know, rather than having other Saiyans as well, you know. So, who knows? Maybe Tarble's going to make an appearance, you know. So, to answer your 15th question, I'm not too big on Kai, to be honest. For the simple fact that the music isn't the same. The voice acting isn't the same. So quite frankly, I'm not too excited about, you know, the Kid Buu saga for Kai. So, I mean, honestly, just really not looking forward to it. So, I mean, who knows? I mean, I know it's going to be the same old stuff with Kai. So, but Kai will never replace the original. Hell no. Hell no. To answer your 16th question, yes, I really did mean that. I mean, why would I not mean something that I say? You know what I mean? I don't just see you guys as fans. I see you guys as friends. I talk to a lot of you guys. I answer a lot of you guys' questions. So, to me, that's a form of friendship, not just, you know, fanship. It's a form of friendship. So, to me, all of you guys are my friends. So, to answer your 17th question, I've only played Uncharted 3. I don't know how the other two are, but I definitely played Uncharted 3, and it was absolutely amazing. So, will I do a review on that? Hopefully, if I do get the game for the PS3, then I will. But Uncharted 3 to me was just amazing, so I might just start off with Uncharted 3, to be honest with you. To answer your 18th question, well, I mean, can you imagine if Vegeta went Super Saiyan 3? But then again, then that'll kill the whole, you know, saga then, because if Vegeta went Super Saiyan 3 right when he fought Majin Buu in the beginning, then that ruins the entire story, you know what I mean? I think he should have became a Super Saiyan 3 after. Like, let's say when he fought Kid Buu or something like that, like, you know, when they were all on the Supreme Kai planet, I think they should have allowed Vegeta to become a Super Saiyan 3 right there. Having two Super Saiyan 3s fight Kid Buu would have been extraordinary. So, I think they should have done the right thing, and I think they should have made Vegeta go Super Saiyan 3 in the Kid Buu saga when they both fought Kid Buu on the Supreme Kai planet. And to answer your last question, I highly doubt there's an evil god, for the simple fact that everybody else who's evil is in hell. I mean, think about it, you know, Turles, Raditz, Nappa, Broly, they're all in hell. So, really, for them to come out and create an evil god, It's very, very highly unlikely. So I highly doubt we're ever going to see an evil devil or evil god or something like that within Dragon Ball Z. I think they're going to stick with the format of, you know, the beings that are above the Kais, like Bills, Whis, and all the other gods and all the other universes. So for there to be another, you know, enemy that is a Saiyan and then he's a god, I highly doubt they're going to do that. I mean, if they do, then I hope it's Broly. But thank you for the questions, Red. It really means a lot, man. Moving on to the next question, which is from Tyna Cook. Hey, Alex, this is my first fan mail submission, and before I get into the questions, I just want to say that I really respect you, man. No one else on YouTube responds to their fan base the way you do, and it's amazing how much of your own time you spend answering our questions every week. Keep up the good work, and hashtag we want shirts. Thank you, man. I mean, I've actually been getting a lot of responses from you guys saying that you want shirts, so since you guys want that, I promise that you will be getting something very soon in which you haven't seen on YouTube before, because a lot of these other shirts are kind of standard, but not mine. Mine are going to be different. Mine are going to be like the asteroids from the heavens themselves are falling upon your anus. Alright, let's get on with the questions. Question number one. What is your favorite thing to do in GTA 5 so far? Question 2, if you were to have redone Dragon Ball GT, what would have you changed or fixed? Question 3, judging on how Vegeta held his own against Bills for a brief moment, if Vegeta finally goes Super Saiyan 3, do you think he will be more powerful than Goku's Super Saiyan 3 form? Question number 4, what movie did you like more, The Dark Knight Rises or Man of Steel? P.S. My friend made a video called Paul Plays GTA 5. Not knowing about your friend Paul, I thought you might like it given that the name. Alright, thank you, Mr. Tyler Cook. To answer your first question, favorite thing to do in GTA 5? Well, I love fucking punching people on the street. I mean, nothing beats that, right? I mean, just walking up to somebody like, hey, how you doing? Pow! Right in the kisser. So, I think punching people on the street is just amazing. But aside from that, probably going out there and exploring, just going out there and seeing what's out there. I actually went hunting before. I was mauled by a bunch of cougars, which I freaking hate. As you saw, I was butchered by a shark. I jumped out of planes. Just overall messing around with the police. So there are a lot of fun things to do in GTA 5. I just feel like they could have done a little bit more. But being that they pushed the limits of both consoles, I respect GTA 5 for how far it's come. I mean, hopefully one day we're going to see GTA 5 for the next-gen consoles. But at this point, there hasn't been a single thing that I've done in GTA 5 that wasn't fun. Everything that I've done in GTA 5 was absolutely fun. I love GTA 5. You know, overall, it's just an amazing game. It's probably game of the year. This game is sick, man. So GTA 5, hands down, one of the greatest games I've played in a long time. Aside from The Last of Us, of course. But to answer your second question, I've answered this way back when, early in my fan mails. But I would have changed the fact that... I would have removed the fact that Goku was a kid. Take out the whole kid portion. No more kid Goku. Dragon Ball GT would be all about adult Goku. Fucking everybody's an adult, alright? Just put it that way. I would have made Pan less annoying, and I would have given her the right to become a Super Saiyan for once. That would have been pretty cool. I would have added Bruce Falconer music, because I feel like that changes a lot. I also would have changed the way some of the voice actors were to do their acting. I would have them do much more aggressive acting than ever before. Kind of similar to Dragon Ball Z, to be honest. What else? I would actually incorporate Vegito in there too. I would incorporate regular Gogeta and regular Vegito. Like, let's say, for example, it was Super 17 versus Gogeta, or Super 17 versus Vegito, or something like that. You know what I mean? Instead of there being three main villains, I would do like maybe four. You know, like, for example, the three main villains were Baby, Super 17, and Omega Shenron. I would definitely add a fourth one, Omega Shenron being the last one. And I would make Omega Shenron become so damn powerful. I would make his particular saga the longest one, because if he's supposed to be the final enemy, then I would throw everything, including the kitchen sink, at him, especially during that final battle, so... to answer your third question, if Vegeta ever went Super Saiyan 3, would he be more powerful than Goku's SS3 form? Considering the fact that when Bills slapped the shit out of Bulma, you know, he unleashed all of his power, then I do think he would, if Vegeta were to put his mind into it. Rather than being arrogant and selfish and talking about, oh, I finally reached the Super Saiyan 3, you know, I would have it to where Vegeta was 110% serious, and if he were to take the fight serious, then I do think he'd be a lot more powerful than Goku. I mean, now that I'm thinking about it, hell yeah, I think he would. And to answer your last question, that's kind of hard. I do think Bane was a lot better than Zod, but I do think in terms of movies, they both carry their own significance. But I can't really say, because I love both movies equally. I mean, they're both great freaking movies, honestly. Hands down, they're both, like, movies to go see. But, if I had to choose one over the other, I would have to say probably Man of Steel. Just for the action part alone. But aside from that, yeah, like I said, I would have to go to Man of Steel, so. But thank you for the questions, my good friend. Moving forward, on the next question is from Bentley Packett. Hey Alex, my name is Bentley. I have been subscribed to you for about a month or two, and you are really doing well. You are one of my favorite YouTubers. Thank you, man. This is my first time sending fan mail, so here come the questions. Question number one. What do you think Vegeta will do in the next DBZ movie? Question two. Do you think Vegeta will kill Bills when he goes Super Saiyan God? Question number three. What if Super Vegeta went versus Android 18 and second form Cell, and he did not let Cell absorb her? Question four. Can Gohan kill one more main villain? Okay, so you're saying, can Gohan kill one more main villain? Question 5. Don't forget Mr. Popo is really strong and fast. I think he will kill Whis. Do you? What the fuck? Hell no. Question 6. Who do you want to come back? Vegito or Gogeta? Question 7. What if Gogeta and Gotenks fused? Final question. Can you and Paul do a fusion dance? That's all I got for today. Keep up the good work. P.S. Screw you, Yamcha! P.S.S. Pollock's fusion name. It's a very interesting fusion name. All right, to answer your first question, what will Vegeta do? I feel like in the next movie, Vegeta is definitely going to train a lot harder than he's ever trained before, considering the fact that he saw how powerful, you know, Bills really is and how powerful, you know, Goku has become. So I do believe that Vegeta will push himself farther than he's ever pushed himself before. In terms of... will he be able to master certain abilities? I really do hope so, because I really do hope that Akira Toriyama pushes the envelope with Vegeta and actually makes him one of the main characters and main heroes for the next DBZ movie. But what will he do? I mean, nobody really knows for sure. To answer your second question, do I think Vegeta will kill Bills when he becomes a Super Saiyan God? No. I don't believe Vegeta would be able to kill Bills, even if he became a Super Saiyan God, for the simple fact that Super Saiyan God could not match up to Bills. Bills even admitted towards the end of the Battle of Gods movie that pretty much Super Saiyan God wasn't all that. Like, you know, he was actually fearful of the form, but once he tested Goku, he was like, you know what, it's not really, you know, what I thought it'd be. So, I think Bills would pretty much obliterate both Goku and Vegeta. Bills has no, you know, he has no weakness in a sense, you know what I mean? Like, his only weakness is food, per se, but do I think Vegeta will kill Bills when he becomes a Super Saiyan God? I don't think so, not at all, man. To answer your third question, is very simple. I think that Super Vegeta would have destroyed Cell and Super 18 if he did not let Cell absorb her. What I would have done was I would have destroyed Android 18 first and then went after Cell. Because Android 18 has no, you know, key energy. Like, she can't, you know, be detected in a sense, because she doesn't give away energy like that, as opposed to Cell, where you can sense Cell's energy. Cell can mask his energy, but to a certain extent. So I do believe that if Vegeta actually freaking tried for one, then he would have totally obliterated both of them, especially as Super Vegeta. Hell yeah. I mean, Vegeta would have no problem destroying both of them. To answer your fourth question, can Gohan kill one more main villain? No. And this is why I say that. Goku had his victories. Gohan has had his victories. Why not give Vegeta one? You know what I mean? I want Vegeta to kill off a main villain. I don't want just Gohan and Goku. I want Vegeta to just step in there and, you know, just really give it his all. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I want to see Vegeta pretty much unleash all of his power and kill a main villain for once. You know what I mean? I would have loved for Vegeta to kill off Cell. Being that it was his fault that Cell absorbed all the other androids because he allowed it to happen and whatnot, so it would have made much more sense, and the fact that Cell, you know, pretty much shot Future Trunks' heart out, so that would have given him a reason to go forward. But, like, allowing Gohan to pretty much kill off another main character, I really don't think so. I think that they should give it to Vegeta, definitely. Hashtag, Vegeta should become the fucking hero for once. I mean, God. Like, Vegeta deserves it more than anybody, to be honest. To answer your fifth question, Mr. Popo killing Whis, not even close. Not even freaking close. Whis would rape Popo, easy. I mean, Popo's strong and fast, don't get me wrong. But against Whis? Hell no. To answer your sixth question, who would I want to see return? Honestly, I want to see Vegito return. We saw Gogeta twice in GT and in the Fusion Reborn movie. Even though they're not canon, we still saw him. So I really want to see Vegito for once. You know what I mean? I think Vegito deserves it. And I think he should have one more crack at it before they silence him off for good. To answer your seventh question, Gogeta and Gotenks fused. That would be very interesting. I mean, why would they fuse in the first place? You know what I mean? That wouldn't make any sense. None of their powers are equal, and the fact that, you know, you would have four beings in one body, I mean, it would be very interesting, but what the hell would you call them, number one? And number two, it's like, how would it be done? You know, the only way I can think of is just Potara earrings, but that's pretty much that. I mean, it's nearly impossible. We're never going to see that happen, sadly, so. And to answer your eighth question, only if Paul agrees to it, yes, we would. But I'm gonna have to lower my power level down to his level, if you know. Nah, I'm just kidding. I fucking love Paul. But thank you for the questions, Mr. Bentley. Anyways, everybody, I'm gonna have to cut this short because I have a lot of things to get through with today. So thank you all for watching this week's episode of Fan Mail of the Week. My name is Unreal Entertainment Gaming, everybody. I hope you all enjoyed. If you guys are fans, remember, don't forget to subscribe to my channel for all the latest news, information, updates. If you guys enjoyed the video, as always, hit the video up with a like and a favorite. Rape that thumbs up button, guys. Stay tuned for next week's episode. I really do hope you guys send me more questions in video format, preferably. Now that I showed you guys how to send me fan mail, I will expect your questions next week. So I hope you all enjoyed, everybody, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys in next week's episode. Peace.